हेलो एवरीवन, लेट मी जस्ट शेयर माय स्क्रीन। दिस इज लेक्चर 3 ऑन R&R स्टूडियो। टॉपिक्स दैट आर कवर्ड इन दिस ट्यूटोरियल आर How to get and set a working directory in R&R Studio. How to read and store a CSV file. How to use built-in functions to explore a data frame. And lastly, importing a data frame in different formats. Different format means .txt file format, .csv file format, Excel SX format and XML format. So let me just switch on to my desktop and I will just go to search bar and I will open RStudio. So this is RStudio interface. Let me just clear everything on the console. So left, right, top corner window is a script window. Then left bottom corner window is the console window. Right upper top corner window is the environment or workspace, and right bottom corner window is files and plot window. We can resize it like this. Now there are few variables that are appearing from the past history on the workspace window. Let me just clear it with a broom. So here there is a broom icon. So let me just use it to clear the workspace. It will ask you, are you sure to remove all the objects from the environment? We'll say yes. Now the environment is empty. So this is how to remove or clear everything from all the windows. Now our R interface is totally empty. Now we will start with the first topic of this lecture. Namely, how to set and get a working directory. So working directory is precisely a folder on which we are going to operate, or we will be using files from that folder that you have already created on your desktop of your device. So let me just show you my desktop. I will minimize this RStudio. And here one can see my R project folder. If I open it from my desktop, it is having a few files which are actually XML file type, TXT file, XLSX file type, and some script files that are with the R practice 1, practice 2, practice 3, and script toolkit. These are 4 or 5 files at the bottom of this folder. In this folder are script files, and first few files are XML, TXT, and XLSX type of files. So we will just note this folder on the desktop. It is with a name my R project. One can see over here. Let me just highlight this part. So my R project is the folder on which I will be working in this lecture, and we will see different built-in functions in R which are used to get the information from the respective R objects. But if I going to work on this folder to use or to see the functions of built-in functions in R, I have to set this folder as my current working directory in R Studio. Okay, so to get the current working directory in R Studio, there is a command, namely get wd empty round bracket. So to get the current working directory, so right now I have not set this folder, my R project, as the current working directory. So R always points to a default directory on our computer, and this is the directory where R will look by default for files you ask it to load for your working purpose. So let me just go to R Studio. In R Studio, to get the current working directory, we will go to console window. The console window is left bottom corner window. So here I will type get wd and empty round bracket. If I press just enter, you will get the current working directory in R by default. So this is by default current working directory whose path is displaying in the console window. So the path is C colon users COIP and documents. But I want to set the folder, namely my R project, on desktop as my current working directory. So in the console window, there are actually two ways to set a current working directory. I have to right now set my R project folder on desktop as my working directory. So there are two ways to do that. The first way is you can go to files and plot window. So right hand corner files and plot window is here. So there you can go. Then you have to go to right top corner of this window. So the right top corner, let me just resize this files and plot window. If you resize this files and plot window, here we can see on right top corner of this window, you have three dots. So you just click on these three dots. If I click on these three dots, a go to folder will get display on your screen. In this go to folder, you go on desktop and you just select my R project folder on the desktop to set as a current working directory. So my R project, I will just choose and I will say open. Once I say open, everything that is saved inside this folder, my R project, will get display. So we already noted that there are five file types. This is XLSX file, some are TXT file. So one can see .txt notation over here. So this is TXT file. This is .csv file, which is saved inside that folder on desktop. Then XLSX type of file, XML file, and other CSV file with a name Captain C Data 2. So these are different data files with the different extensions that is saved inside this particular folder. And after that, one can see there are five script files with the extension .r that are there inside this particular folder. So this, once you say open, it will show you everything that is inside that particular folder. Now I have to set, so still we have not set it as the current working directory. So how will you save this as a current working directory? So in that case, you have to go to more button near a blue gear icon and you have to click on that downward arrow. So when you click on that downward arrow, you will get the command displaying on that particular window, namely set as a working directory. So here one can see this particular command. So here you have to click on that command and say set as a working directory. So let me just click on that command. Now your my R project folder is it has been set as a current working directory. Now you are going to work inside this particular folder only, and you can see in console. In the console, one can see this path: C user COIP oblique desktop oblique my R project. Now my R project is your current working directory. Now if you just go to console and type the command get wd and round bracket, and if I press enter, you will get this path. And the second path is different from the first previous path, which was by default working directory. And right now we have set it my R project as a current working directory. Okay, so this is how to set the required folder on your desktop as the current working directory. Other way to set the working directory is in console. You type set wd. So other way I'm showing you to set as the current given folder as a current working directory. So set wd is the command, and inside the round bracket, which is an empty bracket, inside double colon, you type the path. Okay, so the path is whatever is there above, which we have got by default. So this path you just type C oblique user C colon oblique users oblique COIP oblique desktop oblique my R project. And if you just press enter, that way also you can set the given working directory or a given folder as your current working directory. Yes, so this is the first point that just I want to share with you. It is about how to get and set a working directory. Second thing is how to read and store a CSV file that we will see. Okay, so now we will go to the console. Inside a console also we can work. So let me just press enter. Now it will show you an error because I have not given the path inside the set wd double quotation. If you give this path C colon user COIP desktop my R project, you will not get this error. Now the other topic is we have to how to read and store a .csv file that we have to see. So now what I will do, I will go to console window and I will just give the name first CSV file or whatever name you want that you can give. So suppose I give the name Captain C and is equal to, so Captain C space is equal to space read.csv. So read.csv is the command and it is coming by default. You can see in the blue line, you can click over there. So it will give you a round empty bracket. Inside that you just type new captaincy.csv. So if you just type new captaincy, so actually new captaincy is not the name. You can view here inside this particular my R project folder captaincy data. So C capital and D capital dot CSV file is present. To that I am renaming as just captaincy. Okay, so here inside this double colon I will just type that name that is present. That dot CSV file, it has to be present inside your my R project folder. So that is captaincy data d capital dot csv. Okay, so now if I just press enter, the command has been worked, it is executed, it has been executed. Now what does it mean? The captaincy name is taken by this particular captaincy data.csv file that was present inside your my R project folder. Okay, so now we will see what are the contents of this .csv file, namely captaincy data.csv that you already saved inside your my R project folder on desktop. So now we have read it with the name captaincy only. So now I will just type the command view and inside that I will just type the new name that I gave. And that name is captaincy. And if I just press enter, one can see in the source window what happened. In the source window, as soon as I have executed this command view captaincy, you are getting everything that is It has been saved, or that was there inside the captaincy data.csv file that you have read with the name captaincy. So this captaincy data frame or a .csv file has 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 columns of names, year, played games, how many of them they have won, how many games out of 45 they have lost, and the victory, which is the proportion of won versus lost, or the ratio, you can say. So this is the data frame, content of the data frame or captaincy.csv file, which we have given a different name or a new name, namely captaincy. Okay, so this is read.csv command that we have just now learned. So this command is important. So read.csv command, what does it do? It read and creates data frames from the previous .csv file that you have saved inside your working directory. So view command is also a new command that just now we have learned. And what does it does? It is to see the stored data frame. So I have stored the data frame with the name captaincy, and view is the command that we have used to see the stored data frame. Now I can give you one exercise. So create a new folder on your computer and make it your working directory. Okay, so you just create a new folder and make it your any folder, okay, inside which you will be having some XLSX file or some R script files. So script files, how to create, we have discussed in the last lecture, lecture 2 on R by myself. And then you can have your script files inside that folder, some XLSX files of any type on your fold inside your folder, and you make that folder on your desktop as the working directory, and you can have work on it. So this is how to get and set a working directory, and how to read and store a .csv file that just now I have shown you. Now I will go to the next topic of this lecture, namely we will now see how to use the built-in functions to explore a data frame. Okay, so for example, say this kind of data frame, captaincy data frame. How to explore a data frame, or how to merge two data frames, and thirdly, how to import data frames in different formats in R. These things we will see. So now I have already saved 5 data frames in different formats inside the current working directory, namely my R project on my desktop, and secondly, a script file, namely my data set on R. So that you can also see over here. So here I have this script file, my data set on R, that is saved inside my R project folder. That is my current working directory, just now we have set. Okay, so let me just now clear everything from my console. Let me just drop first of all few things. Then let me just use this broom to clear everything from the console. I will clear everything from the source file. Now let me just resize this files and plot window. Now it's showing the captains is having 6 objects and 6 variables. Let me just fill that variable also. It will ask you whether you want to remove all objects from the environment. I will say yes. Okay, now what we'll do is we will open this my dataset.r, that this script file, you know, is the collection of all commands and objects we have stored for future purpose. So I have stored all the commands inside this my dataset.r script file. Okay, so here I will just open this folder. So let me just open this my dataset.r folder. Now one can see here inside this script source window, this particular folder it has been opened. Now clear arc workspace, the first command is to clear arc workspace. So we'll say, so suppose I have to run just this command, what we will do, rm inside the round bracket list is equal to ls and empty round bracket. So let me just press control enter. So it has cleared the workspace. Now the command on line number 6. So command on line number 6 is this: captain c1 is equal to read.csv inside a round bracket, we have inside double quotation captaincy data.csv. So that particular CSV file, it has to be present inside your working directory. So that's its name, it is written over here, and we are just giving the command read.csv to that. So what does it does? It will do read your captaincy data.csv file with the name now captaincy1. So that's the new name, and now you can view the contents of captaincy data. So in the before a few minutes, I have shown you the same .csv file with a different name, just captaincy. Now I am giving the name captaincy1 to it, and we can view the content, same content with a different name, namely captaincy1. Now how to view the contents of .csv file, that's also kind of repetition. So let me just show you, it's with a view command. So to view the contents of your CSV file, we will use this command on line number 9, and that is view captaincy1. So if I just compile this or execute this command, so I will just press control enter to this line. So now it is showing you that the captaincy1, it has not found. So why this error is coming? Because now I have not, I think, set this as a current working directory. So let me just check my current working directory. So let me just first of all click on those three dots. Now one can see you are in documents and you are not inside that folder. So let me just go to desktop and set my R project as my current working directory. Okay, so that we have to do, otherwise you will get the error like I'm getting over here. Now my R project is my current working directory. Now it will not show you this error if I just compile again this read.csv line number 6. Let me execute it again, and then if I execute this command view captaincy1, if I press control enter, it will not show you an error. Now it will display, one can see now here in the source window, it is going to display everything that is there inside captaincy1. Let me again go to my script file. Now there is a summary function on line number 10. You can see on line number 10 inside a script file, one can see summary function. So what is the summary function? So summary captaincy1, when I say, it will show you all statistical data of all the common columns. Okay, all statistical data of all the columns will be calculated. So let me just compile this. Let me just execute this command. So control enter, when I say, well, you can see in the console window. So can you see this console window? So after the summary captaincy1, so what the summary function is doing, it is showing you all statistical data of all the columns in the R object. Your R object is right now your data frame, namely captaincy1. So in the first column, how many, what's the length, what is the class, it's a character kind, what is the mode, what is minimum, what is maximum, what is first quartile, second quartile, median, mean, maximum. So everything for every column you will get displayed inside the console window with the summary function. Next is the class function. Class function, when you apply on the R object, namely data frame. So what is your data frame? Data frame is captaincy1. So let me just execute this command. So when I execute this command, namely class function, when I apply it on the R object, namely captaincy1 data frame, let me just execute this command. So it will just, let me enter control enter. So it will show you. So class function displays class type of captaincy1, which is the data frame. So what is your R object? What is the class type of this data frame? Actually, captaincy1 is the data frame and that's the class type. So class function will display class type of captaincy1, which is data frame. Okay. Next function that we are going to see is the type of function. Type of captaincy1, if I execute this command, let me just press control enter after this line. What it shows, its list. So type of command returns storage type of file. And here it is the list type. Okay. Here the storage type of the file is the list type. So you can elaborate more on this type of command by using help command. So let me just go to console window. Suppose let me just clear everything from console so that we're not having any problem. So if I just go to help command, and if I type of command. So suppose you want to learn more about this command, you can take help of RStudio. So type of command I just wants to see. If I press enter, it will just show you everything that is related with this command. So one can see in files and plot command, now you see the description. The type of determines our internal type of storage mode of any object. So like that, you will get the information regarding this command. Any command you can elaborate using this help command inside console. Just now I have used it. Okay, now let us go to the next command, that is head captaincy one on line number 13. I am reading on line number 13 inside RStudio, inside a script window. So we have head captaincy 1 3. So head captaincy 1 3, what it will do, it will extract top three rows of captaincy one and it will show you inside the console. Okay, so let me just control enter. Now you can see when I so you just see in the console what has happened. Head captaincy one, so let me just show you the contents of captaincy one. So what are the first three rows? Names are Mahi, Saurav and Azhar, and the corresponding played number of games, won, lost number of games and victory, and all those first three rows of this data frame are extracted inside the console. So what head command do on the object captaincy 1 comma 3? It will extract first top three rows of your data frame. Okay, yes. Now let me just go to the next command, namely the tail command. So tail function, when you apply on the object, namely data frame whose name is captaincy one in this context, comma two, when you apply, so what tail will do? Tail will extract bottom two rows of this data frame inside the console. So let me just run this command. Let me just go to last line of this particular line number 14 that is written in the script file, and let me just press control enter. So when I press control enter, now you can see after this tail inside a console, you concentrate names Pathudi and Dravid, and let me just go to captaincy one. So what are the last two rows? Pathudi and Dravid. So last two rows it has been, they are extracted inside the console. So tail command will extract last two rows and it will be shown in the console window. Okay, let me just go to again my script file. Now str function, str captaincy one, what this function will do, it will show you all structural details of your data frame. Okay, so let me just run this command. So you just go to the last line of this data frame captaincy one and let me just press enter. Let me just do control enter. So if I do control enter, it will show you the structural details of an R object. Your R object is your data frame, and structural details are names, are character kind of data, Y is an integer kind of data, played, won, lost are integer kind of data, victory is a number because it's a fractional, there are the fractional numbers in the last column. There are six objects of six variables. Character names are displayed, years are displayed. So all structural details of an R object are given by the str function when you apply it on R object like the data frame. Okay, next we will see how to merge two different data frames. Okay, so you should have two CSV files inside your working directory. So my working directory is my R object on the desktop. Inside that you should have two CSV files. So let me just check first. So let me just go to files window and let me just check inside this my R project whether am I having two CSV files. Yes, so one can see here captaincy data dot CSV, that is the first file that we are reading with the name captaincy one, and the second dot CSV file is captaincy data two. Okay, so let me just merge these two CSV files. So how will you merge these two CSV files? So let me just first of all read the second .csv file, namely captaincydata2.csv file with the name captaincy2. So how will you do that? You will be doing it with the read.csv function or command, which we have already learned, and you will view the contents of captaincy2. So let me just run the command on line 17. So let me just go to that line, press Control Enter. Okay. It will read your captaincydata2.csv file with the name captaincy2. Now you view the contents of that captaincy2. So for that, I will execute the command on line 18. So press Control Enter. So you see in the script window, contents of captaincydata2 second CSV file are getting displayed. So it is having only four columns: names, drawn, defeat, and formats are the names of those columns, and it is having six rows and four columns. And your first .csv file, namely captaincy1, is having how many rows? Six rows only, and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 columns. Now I want to merge captaincy1.csv file with the captaincy2, which are the names given by me by using read.csv, and we have viewed the contents. Now what we want to do, we want to merge two different CSV files, and that we will be doing with the merge function. So can you see on line number 19 this merge function? Okay, so this merge function will merge two different data frames. So what are the advantages of merging two data frames? Advantages are, it will make data frame more available. Secondly, for improving data quality, merge function is used, and it will reduce the complexity. So when I merge two different data frames, it will be more informative for me. Okay, so now we'll merge captaincy1 and captaincy2 using the merge function, and the command is written on line number 19 in the script file. So let me execute this command on line number 19. So if I run this command on line 19, if I press Control Enter, it will merge two data frames. Now I'm interested in, so after merging, what is the name that I gave? Name is captaincy1 only. Okay. So name is captaincy1 only. So here one can see, after merging, name I have not changed. It's captaincy1. So I will view the content of captaincy1 now, and I should be able to see the columns that are displayed in captaincy2 as well as in captaincy1 together. So let me just compile this command on line number 22, which is view captaincy1. If I press Control Enter, one can see the content of your merged CSV files. So what is the content now? How many columns you got? You have first 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 columns of captaincy1, and then drawn, defeat, and formats. These are the columns in captaincy2. Okay. So last three columns are the columns of your captaincy2 file. So two data frames, they have merged. And by names means by names column, we have merge the two data frames. So names is your name of first column in the captaincy1 and 2, isn't it? With that, we have merged the two data files. So now we will see how to import XML file, TXT file, and XLSX file inside the RStudio. So XML data. So for importing XML file, you need an internet, and first you need to install .xml package on the RStudio. So install .packages is the command to install XML package on RStudio. So you just install .packages capital XML, you type in the console window. So let me just do it. Install packages command will come. This we have already learned in first few lectures on R, and capital XML will be the command. So let me just Control Enter. So this package will get installed on your R. So now it will show you the message on console window. You can see the package XML is, it has been successfully unpacked and installed on your R. So it means that everything is fine with XML kind of data. Now you can import XML kind of data inside R. And now one can see at the top of my script file, I have written library inside a round bracket XML. So after installation of XML data package, you take this library function and press Control Enter. So it means library XML, it has been used now. Okay, so all the properties of this package will get used. And now it is useful while importing XML kind of data. Now, how will you import XML kind of data? Now you can see, first of all, you have to ensure yourself that you have .xml file inside your MyR project folder, that is your current working directory. So here one can see XML file. Captain C data is the name of my .xml file. So that I'm going to import. Now, how will you import? So XML to data frame, Captain C data. So first you write your name of .xml file. XML to data frame is the command, and the name that I have given is the XML data. So let me just run this command on line number 25. So if I do it like this, and if I press Control Enter, it will take your XML file. And now you have to view the contents. So how will you call this or import this XML file? How will you see the content of your XML file? Using view command. So V-I-E-W, capital V-I-E-W, XML data is the name of your XML to data frame that you have used to import it. Let me just press Control Enter. Now you can see in the script window, you have the contents of your XML file displaying. Okay. So now the another type of data, another type of file that we will import is .txt file. So now txt data is the name that I am giving. Read.table is the command. Okay, to import .txt file, you have to ensure yourself that .txt file is there inside your current working directory, and it is there. You can see, let me just highlight. So here .txt file is there. So this file now will call in R and it will import and we will view the contents. So let me just run 28th and 29th command. So when you can run both these lines together and you can see the contents. So .txt file is having this contents. Okay. So this is .txt, txt data you can see in the script window. And lastly, we will see how to import the packages from the user interface to install. So importing data from user interface will need an user interface from RStudio. You have to ensure that you have installed packages, namely read, excel, and rcpp. So you can use the command install.packages to install these packages. What packages I'm telling you? Read Excel, R-E-A-D Excel, R-E-A-D Excel small, and capital R-C-P-P package. Okay, so we will import captaincydata.xlsx file from this method. So first you ensure that .xlsx file is there inside your folder. So let me just highlight that file. So captaincydata.xlsx file is here, and this we are going to import using the method of user interface, using user interface. So how will you do that? So in the top right corner of your RStudio, click on the environment. So let me just clear everything from my environment window using that broom. So yes, I will say, and then you can you see this import data tab over here. So inside this import data, you have to click on the arrow. Okay, so let me just click on this down arrow. Now it will show you these many lines. From that, I will choose from Excel tab. Okay, now this kind of window will get display on your screen once you say that. And here I will browse. So when I say browse, I'm going to see XLSX file, which is here. Inside that command sorry, inside that folder my R project. So here it is the line. Here it is the XLSX file. Okay, so I will click on that and I will say open. So if I click on that and if I say open, the path will get display inside this and the contents of that file also will get display. And in the bottom right corner of this window, you can see the code of this file is getting displayed. Okay, so this is the code of the file. This is the code of the file. So now I will say, let me just go down. I will say import. If I say import, now you can see in the script file, the contents of your XLSX file is getting imported. So using import data, say, data set from user interface also, you can import XLSX file. So we will stop here in this lecture. Thank you.